first of all, you know, how are you enjoying life as a professional boxer, and how's things with Matchroom?
Yeah, it's good. It's fun. It's exciting. Do you know what I mean? To be a part of the Matchroom stable and box under the Matchroom banner. It's everything I've always dreamed of. Do you know what I mean? It's everything that I thought I would have done and could have done, and now I'm doing it. You know, and yeah, I'm grateful.
Now, this is your third professional fight coming up, and again, you're at a major arena at a major event. And I'm just wondering, is there a little bit of pressure on your shoulders to sort of repay the faith shown by your promoters?
The only pressure that I feel is the pressure I put upon myself. That makes sense. Like, I'm so hard on myself, and I'm so critical about my own performances and stuff like that. Like, that's the only time I really feel pressure. Like, Tony and Kev, my coaches, have full faith in me to make sure I perform, and they wouldn't put me in a position where I wouldn't. So, yeah, I'm the only one putting pressure on myself.
Do you know much about Kate Radomska, or are you just focusing primarily on yourself, you know, ahead of this fight?
Not really. I don't know much about her. I know she's lost to Gemma Rueg. I know we've boxed the same girl. I'm pretty sure Judith, who we've boxed, messaged her manager and said it's 60-40 to me. And the only reason it's 60-40 because I annoyed her at the weigh-in. But, yeah, I'm not really like that. I don't like researching people. I don't like, because then you think about it too much. I like going in and a little bit of surprise and see what happens.
Generally speaking, though, has training gone okay? Everything fine?
Say that again.
Has training gone okay? You know, is everything fine ahead of the fight?
Yeah, it's gone really, really well. To be honest, it's probably the best camp I've ever had. Even though I've had two before, but each camp is getting better. Each camp I'm feeling stronger. I'm feeling like I'm trusting the process more. Do you know, it's quite daunting when you first turn over. It's all different. It's all new. And I'm starting to like understand why we do stuff and the way we train and stuff like that. Yeah.
And you know, for those who haven't seen you in action, what could they you know expect to see from you on May the 20th?
I like to have a fight. I've been told off for having too many fights, like in my sparring sessions or in my fights. I try to keep it a little bit more composed this time. I've got 6 rounds instead of 4. But yeah, I like boxing, I like fighting, I like keeping it classy as well, you know, a little bit like technical side of it as well. Yeah,
we know what you can deliver in the ring, but I'm just wondering, because obviously boxing, just like any sport, it's an entertainment based business. So
yeah.
Are you thinking about more about how you present yourself in press conferences, perhaps a bit of trash talking, things like that? I mean, we've seen you having a bit of a push and shove with the girl in your first fight. Are you thinking about that side of the business?
Not really. If it comes to me, then it comes to me. You know, I don't really like that kind of boxing. That kind of boxing to me is, if you have to do that in, if you have to sell a fight, then it's obviously not a big enough fight. Do you know what I mean? And if someone trash talks to me, I find it quite hard to keep my mouth shut sometimes. So I might trash talk them back, but I won't ever like initiate it. Do you know what I mean? I won't ever be like, oh, whatever. But yeah, I don't mind a little bit of banter, a little bit of like back and forth, but I won't start it.
You're obviously on Katie Taylor's undercard once again. I'm just wondering, you know, in your opinion, is she the greatest of all time?
At the minute, yeah. 100%. 100%. She's paved the way, you know. She's made it, like, achievable for women to reach what she's done, you know. Like, before that, there's no one out there, really, that's done anything near what she's done, you know. And to be on another Katie Taylor card, it's huge. And to be on a card where she's called someone out, where she's not done that before as well, against someone who's also under Matchroom, it's massive. It's big.
What are your thoughts on that main event, Taylor against Cameron?
Oh, I don't know. It's a tough one. It's a real tough one. Whenever someone asks me, I can't really pick and choose because I don't know. If Katie Taylor loses in Ireland, that's heartbreaking. But then Cameron's an English girl, you know, like, so no, I'm on the fence big time. Yeah,
just last one on Katie Taylor. Do you think, you know, we need to see Taylor Serrano too? I mean, obviously it's so massive for women's boxing the first time round. I mean, it can only get bigger the second time, right?
Yeah, true. I do think it should happen again, but I think if it is going to happen again, it should be 3 minutes. Do you know? Like, even if it's 10 threes, because there's a few times in them rounds, I can't remember what round it is specifically, but both of the girls have got hurt. Do you know? Imagine if, like, that was a 3 minute round, it would have ended a different way, like, either or, do you know? And 10 threes, if it does happen again, that'd be wicked.
Just generally speaking, for women's boxing, is that the way to go? 3 minute rounds?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's only fair. You know, we're doing the same sport, we're training the same, we're doing the same weight cuts, we're doing the same sacrifices, you know. And there's this whole thing about how we get concussions easier and all of that, but it's not like I'm going in there with a geezer that's 6 foot something, like 20 kilos heavier than me. I'm going in there with someone the same weight, the same like experience. Like sometimes 9 times out of 10 the same age, you know, and it should just be 3 minutes. I train 3 minutes, and I know loads of other girls train 3 minutes, and when you do twos, it's like you blink and it's gone. Yeah.
And just looking ahead for the remainder of 2023, I'm just wondering how many more times are you looking to get back in action for the end of the year?
Hopefully after this fight another 2 more times minimum, hopefully. I'm looking at eyeing up like the English title belt, like the British title belt even. Eyeing that up, seeing what we can and can't do around that. And yeah, hopefully progressing quite quickly, like through the ranks. Being a female, that's what happens anyway. And the weight I'm in, it's quite achievable for me to do that. So yeah.
And when you're not fighting, when you're not training, when you're not in fight camp, what is it that you like to do, away from training, just to relax, just to chill, and just, away from the sport?
I like eating snacks. Listen, I just can't wait until after May 20th so I can eat some crisps and some chocolate. I like going to like music, like watching live music, stuff like that. I just love boxing, to be honest with you. Everything I do is boxing. I work in boxing. I go, you know what I mean? My life's boxing, but snacks and music do it for me as well.
Do you tend to watch a lot of pro boxing at the moment? And if so, who is standing out, do you think? Who do you like to watch at this moment in time? And just men and women generally.
I like going to more live like boxing events. I don't like watching it on TV because it isn't the same. Do you know what I mean? But there's a lot of good people out there at the minute. There's a lot of good like prospects. Skye Nicholson's one of them. Even though she is one of my good mates, I love watching her box. She's proper talented. There's loads of people. All the people down the Matchroom gym, the elite Matchroom gym. It's exciting to watch them, you know, because they're like my friends, and then I see them in there and they're like excelling and beating someone up. And yeah, that's what I love to watch.
Just lastly, because I've seen obviously on social media, you seem to have a close friendship with Skye Nicolson. I'm just wondering, where has that stemmed from? Is it just because of your training together or something like that?
You know what it is? In boxing, it's very difficult to be able to find someone who you can call a friend. You know, it's. Even though in boxing, I've never boxed Skye, we're not the same weight, you know what I mean? But it's really easy for people to turn your back on you and like stab you in the back and stuff like that. And I'm very lucky to have found someone that I trust in boxing. Do you know what I mean? Someone that can beat me up and I can beat her up and it's no hard feelings. Do you know what I mean? And then we'll go to Lakeside afterwards and go buy a pair of trainers or something, you know? Like, yeah, very lucky to have like Skye as my mate, yeah.
How far do you think she can go, in her professional career?
The whole way. The whole way. She's got the most awkward style that you could ever think of. She's a sit back southpaw that comes forward. Do you know? I think she'll be a world champion easily within a year's time, if not a 2 times world champion. And not that because she's my mate, do you know what I mean? I hate to say that just because she's my mate, but I do truly believe in her. She's grafts hard, she works hard, and yeah, she'll definitely do it.